Idaho. Idaho Governor Brad Little, well, really kind of needs to stay at home, it appears. Because for the second time this year, his second in command, Janice McGeachin, well, she took advantage of a constitutional provision, making her acting governor when he's out of state, engaging in performative MAGA antics. As reported by Vice News, Governor Brad Little, Republican, traveled to Texas Tuesday for a meeting with Texas Governor Greg Abbott and seven other governors about immigration and the border. Little is expected to be back in the state on Wednesday night, but on Tuesday, Lieutenant Janice McGeachin, well, also Republican, she issued what she called a fix to Little's executive order banning vaccine mandates. So that now is also prohibits testing requirements. McGeachin posted this tweet. Jesus. Today, as acting governor, I fixed Governor Little's executive order on vaccine passports to make sure that K through 12 schools and universities cannot require vaccinations or require mandatory testing. I will continue to fight for your individual liberty.
Is this weird? Does this sound okay? First, this is weird. So outside of the fact that she broke rank and did all this, but which we'll get to, but so how is that liberty to not even, so I didn't know testing was the enemy too. I thought it was mask wearing and then vaccines. It's also testing. What's the end game here? What's the point? What are we supposed to do now? So fine, you don't want to get vaccinated, but at least you should get tested so we know if you have COVID so that you can at least get the hell out of our faces. Now that's something we don't want. Why? Maybe it's a simple question, but why?
Bro, I have no idea whatsoever. I think these people, they just want it, as in COVID, to just go away, you know, but I'm sure they're the same people who cover their eyes and think they're invisible. But as we know, the actual governor, Governor Little, well, he was not happy. So he said on Tuesday that he'd be rescinding and reversing any actions taken by the lieutenant governor when he returns. He said, I'm in Texas performing my duties as the duly elected governor of Idaho, and I have not authorized the lieutenant governor to act on my behalf. That's what he said in a statement posted on Facebook. Now, this is pretty crazy because it's almost like, you know, when you're stuck between two divorced parents or two parents who do not want to be married. And unfortunately, lieutenant governor, governor, they kind of go hand in hand. But still, having Little step up and say, I'm reversing the things you're doing, that's not stopping McGeachin. Because in addition to her vaccine order, she also tried to activate the National Guard and send troops to the border in Texas. As of Wednesday, my constitutional authority as governor affords me the power of activating the Idaho National Guard, McGeachin wrote to Major General Michael Garshuk, the, I think this Lieutenant General of the state National Guard, in a letter obtained by the Associated Press. So, yep, she's requesting information from you on the steps needed for the governor to activate the National Guard. Really, this is happening.
This is absolutely wild. She's gonna send them down to Texas, right? And if unless I'm mistaken, isn't that where the governor was? It's okay. Yeah. Okay. So she thinks it's 1854 or something, and then the communication lines take a while to get to someone. So the governor will go down to Texas to do whatever he's doing with Governor Abbott to act like he's, you know, fighting. And then the lieutenant governor up in Idaho, it says, I'm gonna send our National Guard down there where he is. And maybe he won't hear about it. He won't know that while he's out, you know, on a business trip, that the teenager's home partying and throwing parties and breaking glass, and then the neighbors hear it. How does she not, okay, first of all, I'm not gonna assume that she didn't think he would hear about it, because that's crazy. She knew he would hear about it. And maybe that was the whole point, because she can't possibly think that she has this authority to do all this stuff. She wants a little bit of attention. It's like, again, you said the kid trapped between two parents. She's like, I need some attention, and the only way I can get attention is if I start kicking over the, you know, the vase in the family room and then drive the car into a wall. Maybe dad will come over and tell me how bad I've been.
She's definitely taking the car up for the drive. You know, she also, you know, took out a second mortgage. Like, she is going to the extremes when daddy is out of town. And it's absolutely wild, but I think it's kind of funny because the National Guard was kind of like, LOL, this isn't gonna happen. They issued a statement saying, I'm unaware of any request for Idaho National Guard assistance under the Emergency Management Assistance Compact from Texas or Arizona. As you are aware, the Idaho National Guard is not a law enforcement agency. This is just wild. And the thing is, it's not the first time McGeachin has tried this. Because in May, while Little had attended the Republican Governors Association annual meeting, McGeachin issued an order banning mask mandates. Little repealed that order and called it an over-the-top executive action that amounts to tyranny, something we all oppose. McGeachin and Little did not run on the same ticket, and in fact, she's already launched a primary challenge against him.
This is
some nasty stuff.
There it is. That's what it is. Okay, so imagine you're a governor and you're gonna get a challenge, but little did you know the challenge would come from within the House, again for the fourth reference that I've made to being in the House. But again, this is the whole setup. There's our answer. In case you were wondering throughout the whole rest of this, what is she thinking? Does she think this is gonna get her somewhere? Is this gonna be effective governing of the state? The people are paying money for you to do this. This is your job. Again, we mentioned Lindsey Graham earlier on in this hour. As a governor, lieutenant governor, senator, it's almost like you don't have to do your normal job once you're in the job. You know this, none of this was gonna stick. You knew this was gonna get rescinded. You knew that it probably is gonna make both of you look bad. How does this further your career? How does this, and number one, serve your constituents? It just doesn't. There's no interest in doing any of that. It's just, let me go and have some fun. Maybe I'll get some attention. After I get some attention, I'm gonna primary this guy. That's the plan.
No, exactly. It's absolutely wild, because the fact is that what she's doing is really undermining democracy. She's supposed to be the number two. The number two's job is supporting the number one. This is not supporting the number one. Like, this person has some serious issues. So to think that she should be in charge and to be the number one, I don't know who's gonna be voting for her, but hey, this is what happens when people are on two different tickets, and this is where we get.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.